Hi guys, welcome to Walk and Talk again. Today I want to talk about programming or coding for the beginners who are actually struggling with it. You know, a lot of it's one of the, first of all, you know, I would just want to say congratulations. If you're struggling even, so means you're trying. So I want to just give you a few tips and tricks how you can, you know, take this, listen to my video and just kind of get something out of it, and you can actually start feeling comfortable with the coding and how you think about it. So, you know, any skill on the planet has basics. A lot of times, you know, people just start looking at those who are actually doing much better in that particular area, and then you lose sense of confidence, saying, okay, well, he's already doing better, and you know, I don't know about this. So especially for the programming, I've seen so many of people, you know, I came across, they did their degrees and done everything, but they're not still able to write the code. And so that's why I'm just making this video for the beginners, because it doesn't take much, honestly. So don't worry about anything. First of all, you're the beginner and you want to do it, and that's pretty much you need. So I'll just give you a few tips and tricks so that in your journey for programming or coding, you feel a sense of confidence and sense of hope that it's absolutely doable. So when I started writing code, I was not able to even understand what was going on. It's an entirely different set of things, right? But then I got a wonderful mentor, teacher, and she kind of break down the basics. So there are always very few things, especially for the programming. I can tell you, man, if you're struggling with the programming, first of all, just try to understand what are the data types, right? Just for the beginners, what are the data types, and see, okay, well, these are the data types available. So, and then there comes loops and conditions, how to manipulate that data and print that data. So that's pretty much about the programming for the beginners. You know, then you can add anything, any length of expertise in future, you will keep adding the knowledge, but that's pretty much it is. You get the data, you manipulate the data, and you just display it, use it in a certain form you want. And that's the purpose of programming. So the best way you can go about it, how to work on this, you know, just take an example of mathematics. How you work on mathematics? Do you run on a computer? Like, you know, not like a typical mathematics, we don't do that actually. We just, you know, work on a piece of paper and kinda, you know, solve our problems, right? Whatever mathematical problem we have. So why programming is different? Because you see people just working on the computer and say that, okay, that's how to start and that's how it should be done, for the beginner especially. No, I think so. It's not, it may not be the exact way for the beginners. You need to learn how to run the program on your paper first. You should know the end result on your paper. If you want to write your first program, run it, write it on your piece of paper, and you should know the result. That's the best way to go about it, because then you know certainly what you're giving to the program and what you're getting out of it. So always run the program on the paper first, especially for the newcomers, for the new, you know, students of programming, right? So you really have to see, you know, what loops you're using, how it's manipulating, what are the conditions in it, and just try to, you know, as many days, as many, you know, few weeks you want to, you know, learn your programming, just just try to, write on a piece of paper and just kind of say, okay, I'm giving this, it should come out like this. And then just keep working towards that in this way, if you're actually struggling. Because it's just the initial days, man, that's going to decide if you are going to be a programmer. Or even if you're not going to be a programmer, you're still spending your time, and if you're not getting it, that's not worth it, right? So just try to write on it. Just try to run it on your piece of paper and see how if you're able to write down or if you're not. Because there is one thing about when you just directly run on the computer is it's a lot of times give you some kind of results, may not be the same. And that's not good. And sometimes I remember a couple of people saying, oh, that's one of the program, something ran. That's not what it is. It's not something ran and it give you some kind of result. It's important. It's like, what do you want and what do you write? You should know what it's gonna give you after. So just try to work on your basics only. And the basics doesn't take like months or anything. It just takes 2-3 weeks only. And then you're on the track, just like any other skill on the planet, just like that. And just no need to worry. And making websites and other things and stuff like that. So everything is just like, start from the basic only. We are manipulating the data and that's pretty much it is. So don't worry about anything. Just only work on your basics for few weeks. You will be on the track. If you wanna do it, you can do it. And it's really one of the beautiful skills you can have. And just take advantage of it. Life is all about computers nowadays. And, new things, new software, everything is all about computers, right? And you're lucky enough if you're a coder or if you're doing your coding. And nowadays, it's one of those skills which even if you're not a programmer, you're not doing it professionally, it has an advantage. And there is no other technology on the planet which actually transform the way the programmers can transform the things, right? So it has a brilliant future in different domains. So just don't give up for no reason. If you have reached to this point where you get to learn this, then definitely you have done something before, because you think about it. And just take it as any other skill. Just start from the basics and you'll be on the way. It's pretty simple. So thank you so much, guys, for subscribing to my channel and supporting me. And as always, I try to come up with something unique, something different, and what I experienced or what is worth sharing. So thanks again. Have a great day. Good luck.